And welcome into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. MLB The Show with a good one coming at you. It's the Seattle Mariners taking on the Minnesota Twins. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. So just about set now, and stepping in for the Mariners, Adam
Leading
Frazier.
Leading off the afternoon for Seattle, the second baseman, Adam.
The line to kick the pitch. Foul ball there.
First pitch, 4 o'clock.
Next offering down in the dirt.
1-1.
Next offering is in for a strike. A swing and a soft liner. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down. So digging in, Ty France. Good contact guy, good defender.
Ty France.
The pitch. And that's in for a strike. And he gets that fastball by him upstairs. That one drilled left field. Here's Jesse Winker. The pitch.
The designated hitter, Jesse.
And that drops in for a strike.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, he had a pretty good look at that pitch and not sure exactly what tied him up there. Couldn't pull the trigger. And perhaps the best pitch he'll see in this at-bat to hit.
And down on strikes. That's out number two.
Mitch.
Now batting Mitch Haniger. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. Next pitch misses, and that's ball one.
The only adjustment he needs to make is his target. If you aim at the outside corner, that slider's going to end up way off the plate. Perhaps look a little more down the middle, and you get it right where you want it.
And a ball and two strikes. Just off the inside corner, and the count's even at two. That one lifted to left. And that is that. Bottom of the first. And here's the veteran outfielder, Byron Buxton. He is quite an athlete. I mean, you look around the other sports, basketball, football, you feel like he could thrive in one of those sports, too. There's a strike. Next one misses, 1-1.
One ball, one strike.
The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Swing and a miss as he chases that one darting out of the zone. Swings and misses, one out. Luis Arraez stands in. He's someone that really beats up on right-handed pitching. The lefties, however, give him a little bit more trouble. One down, base is empty. Swings through the fastball up in the zone.
Well, you put good velocity in the head of the hitter. He's got to get it ready early and then change speeds. Keep him off balance. That's the goal.
Next pitch is outside. 2-2. Kicks and fires. Soft contact in the air, two down. Here's Carlos Correa.
Not shortstop. Carlos Correa.
A wind in the pitch. Just missed. That's inside. Yeah, that's ball two.
That's a really good take right there. Slider down and in. Very difficult to get on the same plane and do anything with.
Next offering is down low. Three balls, no strikes. And the 3-0 finds the zone. Swing and a miss. 3-2 now.
Well, he looks to have some quality stuff on the hill today. Start this outing out. Pepper in the zone. Arm is loose and firing him in there.
Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of it.
Kelman makes the catch, and that'll do it. Top of the second, Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now. And Chris, probably no other player better represents present-day baseball than this guy. A lot of power, a lot of strikeouts, and some walks. Slice down the right side. And a pitch. And a foul ball.
That fastball at the bottom of the zone can be very effective. Just got to keep it on the corners.
Next one is off the plate. And that is ball one. The next offering misses. And it's 2-2. Not even close there. And it's 3-2. Stays alive. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. That's his second strikeout. And now for Seattle, J.P. Crawford. Next pitch downstairs, and it's 1-0. Next offering is in for a strike. 1-1. In there at the knees, and the count 1-2.
You see how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Wanted to try to tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
Righty delivers. Rolled softly, but that goes foul. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. And there are two down. Two outs, base is empty. And up next for Seattle, Julio Rodriguez. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Counts 1-0.
Fought off foul. The next pitch misses. Two balls and a strike. That one in for a strike, 2-2. And now it's 3-2. Big righty strikes out the side. Back at Target Field, and here is Miguel Sano.
Leading off for the Twins, the first baseman.
And the pitch. Ball one, no strikes. Swings and misses. That's strike one. Checks his swing. Now it appeal to first. No swing. Got him. Leadoff man retired here in the second. Now batting Max Kepler.
The right fielder.
The wind of the pitch.
Kepler
just missed.
Ball one, no strike.
And now it's even up.
Looks like a really good fastball today. You can hear that catcher's mitt popping. Looking forward to hearing a lot of that one in this one.
The 1-1 is cut on and missed at a pitch upstairs. Cut on and missed. Struck him out. Back-to-back strikeouts.
It's
Gary Sanchez.
The catcher. Gary.
And he deals.
Sanchez.
Check swing. No appeal. Ball one. In today's game, you look at exit velocity as a measure of process, and if guys are hitting the ball hard, eventually the results usually follow. Gary Sanchez, he is a guy that hits the ball hard. In for a strike, now 3-1.
Man, this guy's got a great feel for his breaking ball today.
Swings and misses, and we're filled up.
Really consistent release point. He's been able to pitch up and down and have excellent command at both locations.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Three up, three down, inning over. Welcome back onto the third inning. Here's Jared Kelnick.
Leading off from Seattle, the left fielder, number 10, Jared.
The pitch.
Kelnick.
That misses, 1-0.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
The 1-0. That misses, and that's ball two. And the righty deals. And they're at the knees. That's strike two. Next pitch misses. And a full countdown. And the tying run is on base.
That's a nice at bat and a great take on 3-2. Probably could have gone either way in that spot around the knees.
Now it's Tom Murphy. Ryan back to work. He swings and misses at the first pitch. 0-1. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it. Next pitch just misses. Now 1-2. Next one misses. Two balls, two strikes. Got him looking. And one away in the top of the third. Here's Adam Frazier. He's 0-1.
Adam Frazier.
And here it comes. And that's off the inside edge. That one at the knees for a strike. Kelnick over at first with one away. Next offering is in for a strike. The 1-2. That misses the zone. 2-2.
2-2.
And the right-hander deals. Grounded to third. Could be two. One at second. on to first, double play, and that's the inning. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's Alex Kirilov.
Leading off for the Twins, the left fielder, Alex.
The pitch.
Kirilov.
And that's ripped into left, base hit. Here's Gio Urshela.
Batting ninth, the third baseman, number 15.
And the pitch. Popped up. Crawford makes the catch, and there's one down.
Well, that's a frustrating end to the at-bat for the hitter right there. I mean, that pitch was right down the middle. I think he got a little too excited, came out of his mechanics. Instead of driving that ball somewhere, he popped it up. Unfortunate for him.
And first offering is fouled off. And now the lefty. Swing and a base hit. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds it second with one gone. Two on, one out. And next is the designated hitter, Luis Arraez. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
This one kicks away from Murphy. The 2-0 is in for a strike.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
Tied up here in the early going. Swing and a miss, and it's a full count now.
Tie a guy up like that, you're feeling like you are in command.
Downstairs, and it misses ball four.
Man, that's a tough one to take on the full count, but I guess he saw it really well. It's a really nice play to play.
Runners on the corners with one gone. Now Correa up to hit. Pitch. That one misses. Ball one. And the 1-0. He swings and fouls one off. First and third, one down. Way inside, gets out of the way.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on. Probably a challenge pitch coming.
And there's a fly ball deep right field. Feeling for the wall. Makes the catch and foul ground. He's in on the sack fly. It's 2-1.
Sometimes all you got to do is your job, and don't overcomplicate things. Keep it simple. Runner third, less than two outs. Put the ball in play, and a nice job with the sack fly.
The pitch. On the ground, right side. They get the force. That's the inning. Back in Minnesota, now the number two hitter, Ty France.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
Well, the offense has gotten going, and a pitcher wants to go out there, have a real quick inning, get those guys back into the dugout so those bats can stay hot.
A swing and a soft liner, and there's one away. In now is the Mariners DH, Jesse Winker.
The designated hitter, Jesse.
Pretty good job on the mound in this one, Ziggy. It feels like we've seen a lot of off-balance swings.
Yep, just one free pass, and obviously he's not a big strikeout guy, but he gets soft contact and he gets outs.
Next offering is in for a strike. One and two now. And a foul ball, he stays alive. on the ground right side. Slides, but it gets by him. And now it's the cleanup hitter for the Mariners, Mitch Haniger.
Now that, the right fielder, Mitch.
Here comes a pitch. Check swing, but he went too far. That's strike one. Next pitch inside. One ball, one strike. Right-hander kicks, deals. And a count one and two. At the belt and fires. And a foul ball.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Stays alive.
Also really good at bat. What I like about this guy, his bat stays in the zone for a long time. Gives him the ability to foul off tough pitches.
Got him swinging. He chased the changeup, and there are two outs. Now Eugenio Suarez up to hit now. He was a strikeout victim his first time. He is very much your typical power hitter. I'd say he falls into the three true outcomes category.
Well, we've seen more and more of that lately. The ability to drive the ball to slog is getting heavily favored over any discipline or strikeout concerns.
There's a strike. Winker leads off first with two down to the inning. Check swing went around. One and two. Righty to the plate. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Next pitch off the play. It's two and two. Next one misses, and the count's full.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score.
And a swing and a miss. And that is that. Bottom of the fourth, and now the first baseman, Miguel Sano.
Leading off for the Twins, the first baseman, Miguel.
The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. And a good fastball to start him off at strike one. 0-2 as he waves at that one.
Another 0-2 count right here. Pitcher just in the driver's seat. He can go anywhere he wants to go right here.
And down on strikes he goes. And that's the first
now
out.
Batting, right
Max
fielder.
Kepler at the plate.
Back. Kepler.
A wind and a pitch. Just off the inside edge. Next one is off the play. 2-0. Next pitch misses outside. Ball three. There's a strike, 3-1. Left field, that's bad. He can't get there, and that should be extra bases. Now around second, going for third. Save! So one gone with a runner at third. Now Gary Sanchez. Pitch. That one off the mark, and that's ball one. They say it went. Check swing, but he went too far. Gonna count one and two. Got him looking. And he's down on strikes. for the second time today. Here's the left fielder, Alex Kirilov.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed.
Left hand batter waits. Now 1-1. Two outs with a runner at third. Next offering is in for a strike. That hits the dirt. 2-2.
Two balls, two strikes.
Got him. Picks up strikeout number 7. We go to the top of the 5th, and stepping in for the Mariners, J.P. Crawford.
The shortstop, J.P. Crawford.
And a pitch. In for a strike, strike 1.
Not what he's looking for there in the 0-0 count. Looks like he wants the ball down in the zone.
That one pushed to the left and foul. The 0-2. That's inside. Now 1-2.
I don't think he was trying to miss by that much in an 0-2 count. Just tried to overthrow that pitch.
And he deals.
That's a really good take.
Left hand hitter waits. Stays alive.
Well, he's desperately looking for that swing and miss. He's going to have to just change speeds a little bit, try to move it around, create just a little bit of illusion at the end.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. 2-2 down. Oh, that drilled him. In there, he's safe. Julio Rodriguez up next for the Mariners.
The center fielder, Julio.
And a pitch. That one is upstairs. Just a slow ground ball this time. Polanco gathers and throws to first. One away here in the 5th. And now for Seattle, Jared Kelner.
The left fielder, number 10, Jared Kelner.
The right hander back to work. Just off the outside part of the plate. And the 1-0 misses low. That one missed, now 3-0. Appears they're working around him with the base open, Singy.
Well, you know these 2-0 counts, Boo, they're just not what they used to be, and we sound like old guys when I say that, but ultimately this is a strategic game, and you expect to see this type of approach by the pitcher in this situation.
The 3-1 in for a strike, full count. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball 4.
Well, they didn't give him anything to hit, and now with runners on first and second, they've set up a double play opportunity. So not a terrible result.
So out of the pen comes the right-hander, Jarrell Cotton, trying to protect this lead.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and he needs a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
And a pitch. Murphy in the box now takes a called strike. Crawford over at second. Kelman over at first with one away. Next pitch misses inside. 1-2 the count. Next one is off the plate. Ball two. That one ripped. He gets there to make the play. A nice running grab. And there's two down.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity, but competitor like now him, he is looking forward to making up for it in his next at bat.
And a pitch. And first offering is fouled off.
Well, he knows they don't want to give him anything to hit, but when you've got opportunities to drive in runs, you've got to expand the zone. He's capable of going out there and doing damage with it.
Kirilov makes the grab, and that is that. Back here at the ballpark, Gior Shela steps in.
Leading up for the Twins, the third baseman, number 15.
And here it comes. Right through there for a strike. And ball one. The wind of the pitch. That's down and in. That one fouled off, 2-2. Bounced up the middle, and that squirts through. Byron Buxton, the next Twin up to hit. This guy has turned into a beast. The pitch gets the outside corner with that one. Ball down the line. Kelman drifts towards it. One away.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
The pitch. That one blasted deep to right. And it's off the wall, but foul. Now the 0-1. Foul ball. And now the lefty. Ground ball right side, could be two. To Crawford for one. Double play. And that'll do it for the inning. Go to the top half of inning number six. And here's the first baseman, Ty France. A wind to kick the pitch. And there's a ball. So two balls and no strikes. The 2-0 is in for a strike. Two-one pitch is in there, and the count is even. Slowly on the ground to short. Correa over to first. Now one gone in the top of the sixth. Here's Jesse Winker.
Now that designated hitter, Jesse Winker.
Cotton back to work. Gets him to chase after that one.
Well, it looks like he just got out of himself a little bit right there. He's looking for a ball in, and to attack that pitch looked like a half-hearted swing.
This looks like extra bases. Around first, heading for two. And the tying runs at second base with a double. Now batting Mitch Haniger.
The batter. The right fielder, Mitch Haniger.
The pitch. Swing and a miss. And a good eye there. In the air, right field. Pretty well struck. it's off the wall. Throw to second, but he's in there. And a run comes in to score. Now Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now. And a pitch. Look out, almost got him upstairs. Next offering is downstairs.
Struggled a little bit in this one. Couple of strikeouts earlier, but doing a much better job in this at bat to get ahead and find a good hitter's count at 2-0.
Here's a 3-0. And that's in for a strike.
Take it all the way on 3-0 right there. And as a hitter, you're saying, why couldn't I get that pitch earlier in the count when I'm looking to swing?
Swing and a miss. 3-2 now.
Well, just threw that fastball by him, elevated. And if you're not looking up in that location, very difficult to catch up to, especially with that velocity.
And ball four to a board. J.P. Crawford gets a chance to hit.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
And he deals. On the inside corner for a strike. One out. Runners at first and second. Next offering is down low. The 1-1.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
On the ground at first. Could be two. Over to second for one. Double play. What a twin killing to end the inning. Bottom of the sixth. And now for the Twins, Carlos Correa.
For the Twins, the shortstop, Carlos.
The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. That one missed.
Well, a mistake right here could untie this ball game. If you're the pitcher out there, you just want to be a little more cautious.
And it's fouled away. Swing and a miss. 1-2. Next pitch is downstairs. And a swing and a miss. And one out now. The batter now, Jorge Polanco. The wind of the pitch. And there's a foul ball. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, you can't really adjust your game plan for that last pitch. Guy hasn't thrown it very much. You got to focus on the stuff that he's throwing up there most of the time.
Stays alive. Next offering misses, and the count is 2-2.
Well, this is a guy that can be frustrating for pitchers because he fouls off so many pitches and grinds out the at-bat. I'm sure there's some times where pitchers would rather just give up a first pitch single than have to waste six or seven pitches on one hitter.
And here it comes. And that one fouled off. Kicks and deals. There's the strike up high, and it's 0-2. And down on strikes, and the Twins go 1-2-3. We go to the top of the seventh, and stepping in for the Mariners, Julio Rodriguez.
The center fielder, Julio.
The pitch. And there's the strike. The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike. The 1-1. Soft contact in the air. Polanco pulls that one down. One down. Here's Jared Kelman.
The left fielder, number 10, Jared Kelman.
And a pitch. That's in there.
Well, we call that keyhole. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
That's a bullet, but it goes foul. And the right-hander deals. And one and two. Next offering is fouled back. Right-handed reliever. Comes up empty as he chases that one into dirt. Out on the drop, third strike, two gone.
Well, maybe approaching this at bat with a bit too much determination. Sometimes you just got to let the game come to you.
And the right-hander back to work. Murphy in the box for the third time today as he takes that one off the plate. Next offering is in for a strike. So now one and two. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And the Mariners set down 1-2-3. Set for the last half of the seventh. And now the right fielder, Max Kepler.
For the Twins, the right fielder, Max.
And a pitch.
Kepler.
Well, on paper, it's favorable to have a fairly quick inning here with two of the three hitters he's set to face batting from the left side, same side he throws from.
Next pitch is outside. And that one is lifted in the air, and it's caught for the out. Here's Gary Sanchez now.
He's a big, strong guy, can untie this game with one swing.
Sanchez.
The wind of the pitch, and that's down and away. Rolled over to third, and he grabs it in foul ground. The wind of the pitch. That misses the zone, and it's 2-1. The next offering misses, and the count is 3-1. 3-1 is on the way. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Pulls it down, and there's two gone.
Now just about to hit that century mark, 100 pitches for this game.
Now batting, left fielder.
Here's Alex Kirilloff.
Alex Kirilloff.
The pitch. And that's downstairs and outside. That one ripped right center field. And it's off the top of the wall. In with a double, and the go-ahead runs at second with two out. And next for Minnesota, Gio Urshela. And he's already singled in this game. Line drive, that's a base hit out of the left center field. Around third. The tag, and that's out number three, inning over. Giovanni Moran. On to pitch out of the pen here.
Number 71, Giovanni Moran.
All set for the start of the inning. Here's Adam Frazier. The wide to kick the pitch.
The second baseman.
Out to center. Buxton under it. And there's one away. And up next for Seattle, Ty France.
Number 23, Ty France.
The pitch. Ball one, no strikes. Next offering is in for a strike. The 1-1. And downstairs. Good eye in that spot. And the 3-1. Top of the zone for a strike. 3-2 now. On the ground to third. Oh, the throw is wild. And he's into second base with one away as the go-ahead run. So a change being made out at second. On the pinch run for Seattle, Billy Hamilton. One out, runner at second. And now, Jesse Winker.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is, I want to stay square to the plate, try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
First pitch, just misses.
Yo, Boog, if you're that base runner at second base, you want to be quiet out there. Not bouncing around, not distracting your teammate, the hitter. Make sure that he can clearly focus on that pitcher and that release point.
Next pitch downstairs, and that's ball three. Left-hand batter waits.
That fastball, even though it's up, that's the velocity you want to go after. Low 90s, a lot better than trying to hit the high 90s.
And a 3-1 on the way. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
Well, notice they've been pitching him hard inside, and the key is, if you're going to make a mistake, you've got to make it off the dish. If it leaks out over the plate with this kind of power, you'd be asking for a new baseball.
Got him looking. Two gone. Now and now here is Mitch Haniger. Mitch. Ripped to third. Zips it across. That ends the frame. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Sergio Romo. And he probably has a little extra in the tank facing his former team. Dylan Moore getting loose there. He's now in the game at first.
Number 25, Dylan.
Back at Target Field, there's Byron Buxton. I think when you contemplate him as a player, the first thing you think about is defense, and you think about that great arm.
I also think about the speed. If he can get on, that's going to give one more thing for that pitcher to think about.
Next offering is down low, and that is ball one. Next one misses. Two balls, no strikes.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
The next pitch misses, and now 3-0.
I almost feel like he's frustrated a little bit. He wants to be challenged.
That one fouled off. Righty delivers. That one misses, so a leadoff walk. No outs, runner at first. Luis Arraez stands in.
Leadoff man is on. You got to be looking for the bunt here. Trying to get him into scoring position.
And he deals. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
If you're a base runner, you got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Over to first, and he's safe. The go-ahead run aboard at first. Nobody out. Another throw over. And he's back in that time as well. Next offering is downstairs. Working down to the zone to start the at-bat, looking for that double play ground ball.
Yeah, back-to-back sinkers there. He's looking for some weak contact or to get this hitter to roll off.
And there's one down. Lay goes to first now, but he's back in. And here comes Carlos Correa.
Well, a pretty good speed over there at first base. I think the pitcher's got to slow everything down. Hold the ball a little bit, step off. Just try to break the rhythm and timing of a potential base dealer.
First offering misses the mark.
Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or run and hit.
Next offering is down low.
Runner.
Buxton on the run. Pitches low. The tag, and he's out at second. Here comes the pitch. And that one fouled off. Two outs. And fouled off. The kick, the 3-2. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive.
Well, he's having a tough time getting a pitch by him. As a hitter, you feel pretty confident that you're seeing different pitches still able to make some type of contact.
Slow ground ball to the right side. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. New arm out of the bullpen, Jorge Alcala.
Number 66, Jorge.
Welcome back. Stepping in, the long ball threat, Eugenio Suarez.
Well, look out here. The third baseman. He's going to come up ready to swing Eugenio in this situation. Suarez.
Puts it in the air out towards left center. Buxton gets under it. And there's one down.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
And a pitch. Crawford in the box now takes a called strike. Up and in, and he gets out of the way. Righty to the plate. And that one is in for a strike. Just misses the mark outside the zone.
Home plate umpires try to tighten things up a little bit.
And a payoff pitch. And that's ball four. And now for Seattle, Julio Rodriguez. This is what stat nerds like myself might call a high leverage situation.
Yeah, Boog, not sure what the numbers say, but clearly an at-bat that could change the course of this game dramatically.
First pitch, not close.
Maybe losing command a little bit after the walk. Next pitch, not even close.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Wow, that's 89 on the gun, and it's a changeup. It's like good hitting if you're looking for it, but because of the speed differential between the fastball and that pitch, really hard for a hitter to get on time with it.
No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's two away. And stepping in for the Mariners, Jared Kelman.
Left fielder, number 10, Jared Kelman.
Alcala back to work. Out towards right center field. Back there. Hits the top of the wall. Throw is wide. He's off the bag. And the winning run scores. So here's Murphy now.
The catcher, number two, Tom
Murphy. The pitch. And that's in there at the knees. Man on second, two down. A little out front there as he swings through it.
Well, you can't expect to get a great pitch to hit with an open base and a runner on second. He's going to have to really tighten up his sights here, make sure that he can barrel up the ball.
Swing and a miss, and that is that. Welcome back. Please. And here comes the closer, Paul Sewald. And he'll work on holding this lead. All set for the bottom of the ninth. Now the cleanup hitter for Minnesota, Jorge Polanco. And there's no doubt that they'll feed off the energy from this crowd, right?
I mean, yeah, I'd say the intensity level has gone up a few notches for sure.
First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Wonder how much of a distraction those fans behind home plate are to the opposing pitcher. I mean, they are into it. They're trying to will this claw back into this ballgame.
One run game, bottom nine. Pitch misses, 2-1.
2-1, 1-strike.
Two and two. And a foul ball. Kicks and fires. Got him looking. And that's the first out. Here's Miguel Sano.
A lot of times you're looking for a guy to get that tying run on base, but because of the power, you want him to tie up the game with one swing here.
And a pitch. Inside, just missed. Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. One one now. And that one a little bit high.
Well, an interesting situation. One swing, you can tie up the ball game. But if you're patient and work a walk, then you bring the game-winning run to the plate.
Next pitch is outside. And the righty deals. And a swing and a miss. Now two out. Now batting Max Kepler.
The right fielder, Max Kepler.
And the right hander back to work. That's through there for a strike. Here's your one. Good eye right there. A one-run lead here in the last half of inning number nine. Swing and a miss. That is strike two. And it's even up. Next pitch misses. 3-2 now.
Big pitch coming right here. Last thing he wants to do is put the tying run on base, but he can't groove one either.
Line drive. He's got it. Ball game. And the Mariners hold on to win a tight one as this one ends as a one-run ball game. A 3-2 final score in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
Our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Seattle Mariners, 3 runs, 6 hits, no errors. They left 8 men on base.